Oh Lord, we thank you for this beautiful time that you've given us to worship you. Hallelujah. There is nobody else that can compare to your majesty. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. We pray, Father God, that you will fill us with the garment of praise. Hallelujah. Every tongue praise you. Every knee bow before you. Hallelujah. Let our whole being worship you, O Lord. Is there anybody that can match your greatness? O King of Kings and Lord of Lords, O blessed God Almighty, we worship you, Jesus. And as we worship you, we pray that you will arise amidst us, O Lord. Arise, take your place, be enthroned on our prayer.
One thing we ask of you, one thing we need is worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing, arise, 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 arise. One thing we ask of you, amen, one thing that we desire, that as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing, arise, 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 arise. We lift you up, say we lift you up,
amen.
We lift you up on our praise.
One more time, we lift you up,
we lift you up, we lift you up on our praise.
One last time, let's say, we lift you up,
we lift you up, we lift you up on our praise.
Arise, 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 arise.
Take your place, be enthroned on our praise. Arise, King of Kings, Holy God, as we sing, arise, 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 arise.
Arise, O Lord. Arise amidst, O Lord. Hallelujah. We lift you up on our praises. King of Kings, Holy God, We worship you and we bless you and we say, arise, O Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. The days that we live in are days of uncertainty. These are the days which have been proclaimed in the Word of God as the last days. As you can evidently see, all around us, there is so much of pain and chaos. There is no more humanity left. There is no more love left. Hallelujah. It is people against people, nations against nations. Hallelujah. The last days are identified with many plagues, many kind of deadly diseases. Hallelujah. That's exactly what we are witnessing today. Dead bodies strewn all over. People have no more strength to cry. This is the very last days that the Lord proclaimed. These are the days of Elijah. These are the days of David, where the tent of praise is going to be rebuilt. These are the days where the Lord is going to come with all His glory. Hallelujah, with all His glory, with all His angels, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. Hallelujah, let us welcome and let us prepare us. Let us prepare ourselves and everything that is with us to meet this Lord Almighty when He comes one day, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
At the trumpet's call, lift your voice to the year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill, salvation comes. Behold, He comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice to the year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill, salvation comes.
Hallelujah.
These are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of Solomon, David, building a temple of praise. And these are the days of great harvest,
the fields are
wide in your world. We are the laborers in your declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, He come, shining on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice to the year of Jubilee. Out of Zion till salvation come. Behold, He come, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice to the year of Jubilee. Out of Zion's hill, salvation comes.
Let's declare,
there's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no God.
One last time.
There's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. Be holy, come, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. The year of Jubilee, out of Zion's hill, salvation come. Be holy, come, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. The year of Jubilee, out of Zion's hill, salvation come. Who was and who is and who is to come?
Come on.
Who was and who is and who is to come? Who was and who is and who is to come? Who was and who is and who is to come?
Hallelujah. This is the Lord that we serve. He was and he is to come. Hallelujah. As he comes, riding on the clouds with all his majesty, behold, there's going to be a new earth. Behold, there is going to be a new sky. And as the word declares, everything would become new. And the Lord will be amidst all his children. There shall no more be tears. Hallelujah. As the word of God declares, the glory of the Lord fills the earth. Hallelujah. As the waters covers the sea, the glory of the Lord fills the earth. The glory fills the temple. And the glory fills our hearts today as we worship Him. Hallelujah. So let us shout it louder. Let us shout His name and make His praise glorious. As we declare the name of the Lord and as we praise His name, Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. Every demon shall flee. Every sickness shall be healed. Every curse shall be broken. That's the power of the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He reigns all over us. And let us welcome once again for Him to come and reign over our lives this evening. Hallelujah. Come, Lord Jesus. My God, we pray that You will reign over lives, O Lord. Hallelujah. Forever and ever, we submit ourselves to be reigned over by You. Hallelujah. We submit ourselves to be ruled over by You, O Lord. Forever and ever, O King of Kings and Lord of Lords, be glorified in our lives, O Lord. Hallelujah. My God, You reign forever and ever. You stay the same.
Shout it out, shout it out, let Your glory go.
Sing it out, for the Lord is
good. Shout it out loud, You are glorious.
Let's come on, face. Yeah, yeah, yes, yes, Jesus. We praise You, Lord.
It louder, Jesus, we shout Your name. Jesus, we make Your praise glorious. You are glorious.
Hallelujah. Let's sing. Amen.
Shout Your name, Jesus, we make Your praise glorious. You are glorious. Jesus,
we shout Your name. Jesus, we make Your praise glorious. You are glorious. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus, You are glorious. We shout Your name. We praise Your name. Hallelujah. We declare all Your goodness in the assembly of Your people. Hallelujah, there is none like You. There is nobody like You, Lord. Oh, Jesus, we bless You. There are times where Jesus calls upon you and me to trust in Him and follow Him. Sometimes the trust that we place upon Him can make us walk on deep waters. The waters that will make us drown on a normal day, on a normal scenario. The same waters will support our feet to walk on it when Jesus is with us. So let us pray tonight that we will not walk according to our sight, but we will walk according to our faith. Like how it is spoken in Romans 8, let us be led by the Spirit of God so that we will be the children of God. Let us pray tonight. Spirit, lead us deep into the waters where You actually want us to be. We love You, Lord. We bless you, Jesus.
You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where feet may fail.
There I find you in the mainstream, when oceans steam,
my faith will stand.
And I will call upon your name.
My soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours, you are mine.
How many of you can do this tonight? If you're willing to be led by the Lord, if you're willing to be taken deeper into the presence, if you're willing to be taken deeper into the mysteries, just allow Him to build you. Just allow Him to take over you. Even if you feel that you're already drowning, keep your eyes above the waves. Hallelujah. Nothing can drown you, brother, sister. Dear brother and sister, nothing can drown you. Just keep your eyes above the waves. Within no time, you will feel the embrace of God. Just call out the name of Jesus tonight. The addiction of drug is breaking us. We pray and worship God. Just call out the name of Jesus. The wrong hands under which you are stuck, the wrong relationships that you have entered, just call out the name of Jesus and you will find His embrace, and you will find Him lifting you from the very waters that were trying to drown you.
I will call upon your name. Keep my eyes upon the
We belong to Jesus. I belong to Jesus. My everything belongs to Jesus. How many of you can agree with me tonight? How many of you just can join with me and praise Him and say, I belong to You, O Lord. Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. Marabalaka Shandaraba.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever You will call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will make me stronger in the presence of my Savior. Speak it, lead me where my trust is without water. Let me walk upon the water whenever You would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will make me stronger in the presence of my Savior. And I will call upon Your name. I am Yours.
Yes, Lord.
And You are mine. Oh, for I am Yours. And You are mine.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Stand in the midst of the multitude, stars of every tribe and tongue. We are Your people, redeemed by Your blood, rescued from death by Your love.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, by the blood of Christ we stand. Every time, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praises to the Lamb.
Every tongue, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praises to the Lamb of God.
Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By the blood of Christ we stand. Every tongue, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praises to the Lamb of God. Giving praises to the Lamb. Giving praises to the Lamb of God. Giving praises to the Lamb of God.
Yes, Lord. Every tongue, every tribe, every nation will praise you. And so are we who stand before your throne and praise you. We give you glory, honor, power and praise, O Lord. And belongs to you and you alone, O Lord. Accept this worship of your children. And arise amidst us with all your glory. Continue to minister to us, O Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Dear people of God, I greet you all in Jesus' name once again. Before we dive into the Word of God, let us look to God in prayer. Our loving Heavenly Father, Father God, you are the source of all truth. And Lord, you are called the God of Comforter. When we go through these deep and troubled waters, when there are so much losses all around us, when we are experiencing pain and agony, and we are helpless and unable to do anything, Father God, it is at this time, Lord, we come to seek your face. Because you are a God who comforts, you are a God who sends your word and heals your people. And you are a God, Father God, who is called the El Roi, who always watches over us. Today, Father God, we come to you to hear your heart, O Lord, concerning us today evening. Hallelujah. We pray, Lord, every word, every meditations of our heart will be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. Holy Spirit, we humble ourselves for your absolute control. In Jesus' name, Amen. Once again, I greet you all in Jesus' name. Today, I've come with a very prophetic word that will encourage you and it also equip you. I believe in Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The topic for today's message is love that seeks. Love that seeks. One of the very profound pictures of the love of God is that love came in search of you and me. We never went in search of his love. Or in fact, we were in a position where we wouldn't have even known this love that existed unless that love had come in search of us. That's the very true, profound truth for all of us. So this love that seeks, if you want to find the power of this love that is depicted in the proverb of the lost sheep, you will find it so interesting, so profound, so deep, that you know there are 99 sheep at care of the shepherd. They are all safe, they are all happy, they are all being led by this amazing shepherd. And in all those 99, he finds that one more is missing. Now this is love. Love, you know, that just overlooks everything. Love is very concerned and it is very to the point, and it is looking for the ones it loves. So this shepherd, and he finds that one is missing. The beauty of the shepherd is, it says in the word of God that he leaves the 99 and he comes in search of that one. Now if you really want to understand the power of this love that comes in search of you and me, you should understand God is looking for that one. He is not concerned about the 99 sheep. He is concerned about the 99 sheep. He has left it in a safe place. But he is equally or more concerned about the one that is lost. So he comes in search of it. And he does not go back unless he finds that one sheep. And this beautiful picture that we find in the Bible is that he lifts the sheep and carries it over his shoulder and joyfully returns to the rest of the 99 sheep. Now today I want to share about this love that comes in search of you. And no matter where you are, no matter how you are, receive this prophetic input today that this love has come in search of you. And let me tell you, this love is relentless and it will not stop unless the love finds you. This love will not stop until the time it finds you and it makes sure that you are safe in the hands and the arms of this beautiful shepherd once again. Hallelujah. Today you might look lost, probably you are full of agony, or today you may be in a situation where you lost somebody you loved, or you are in a situation of panic and anxiety every day because somebody whom you love, somebody you care for is hospitalized or down with some disease, or it could be a situation where you've been neglected and you've been thrown out, you've been discarded, or probably you were in a situation where you were the most wanted and you have been helpful to many people, but in spite of all your help, you know, today people don't want you. They have sucked out everything that is from you and they have left just you alone. If you are in that position, let me tell you, it is you that exactly that love is searching for today. It is you that the love is come to search for. Hallelujah. Because you feel all left alone, you feel all vulnerable, you feel all alone, you feel all broken and disheartened, but it is God's mission that He will come to seek you, and He is coming to seek you, that He is going to restore you, and He is going to take you to the safety of the rest of the sheep, or I would say He is going to take you to the safety of the arms of the shepherd God. Hallelujah. So this love that seeks is very powerful. In Luke chapter 19, we find the story of Zacchaeus. We've been reading it right from our childhood days, from Sunday school up until now. You find that love that really cares about people. You know, here in this episode of Zacchaeus, you'll find it very interesting that Jesus came and made the first contact with Zacchaeus. Love that cares. Now, he was a tax collector and everybody hated tax collectors in those days. It is because, you know, they are these Hebrew people, they are part of the Jewish nation. But they were appointed by the Roman officials to collect taxes from Jewish people. This was found by all the other Jews as if this man was a traitor, and he has risen up to harm his own people by way of collecting taxes. And also in those days, you know, the tax collectors were given authority and they had even bodyguards for themselves. They had soldiers, you know, in case there something goes wrong, or they had to impose some people into custody. There were always Roman soldiers also around them. They were people of power and wealth. The wealth was one, the Roman government paid them, and the second thing is, you know, they were able to extract money from poor people more than what they owed to the government. So they were kind of rich, but they were not accepted in their own society, with their own people. Now Zacchaeus was one such person, and all the others could look at Zacchaeus as the tax collector, as the hated one, and they were looking for an opportunity to do some harm to him. You know, it was everybody's hate on that one person. But you know, nobody was able to see beyond what he is at that moment. Nobody was able to look at the heart that was receptive for the good news of God. Nobody was able to see that he is a man who was willing to change. Nobody was looking into the heart of the man that was lonely. Nobody was able to look at Zacchaeus as a man who is searching God. Everybody thought he is a no-God person. But whatever man was not able to look into him, it is exactly what the Lord Jesus was able to look into him. And we find Jesus coming and standing beneath that sycamore tree, and then beneath the fig tree, and he calls Zacchaeus down and he says, "I want to stay with you tonight." Now the change is so amazing. You see, when Jesus goes there and he has his dinner with him, There is the beauty of Jesus that he cares deeply for the hurt soul. Nobody in his right sense in the Jewish community will go and identify himself with the tax collector. So obviously the tax collector was only left with friends who are notorious, you know, who are people of other faith other than the Jewish people, or you know, all the wrongdoers, all the people of authority who were very hard on people. These were the kind of people who he had to associate himself with, no other go. But it is at this person Jesus was concerned, and he was ready to make a difference in the life of Zacchaeus. And so he goes and he identifies himself with this hated tax collector. People around him wouldn't have understood the significance of what Jesus is doing, but it made a world of difference for Zacchaeus, and you know the rest of the story. So today let me tell you, Jesus cares for you. No matter how hated you are, no matter how distanced you are, nobody is able to see your heart. Nobody is able to see your good intentions. All people could see is your failures. All people can see in you is that you are jobless, you are moneyless, you are not married, you don't have a proper income, you don't have a family, you don't have a future, you are good for nothing. Just people are able to see only all this. But you know, my Jesus, he cares for you and he is able to see beyond what you are today. Hallelujah. Because that is supernatural. He is able to see in the light of what he has made you to be. So cheer up, people of God. Jesus cares for you. He has come. He is coming. And right now, for some people, he is standing next to you because he cares for you. Love has come seeking you. Second thing is, we find love that corrects. You see, in the case of Zacchaeus, nothing supernatural had to happen other than Jesus going and standing in his place. And the transformation of Zacchaeus was so super. This Zacchaeus, he was willing to share half of his wealth to the poor. And he says, Lord, if I had extracted unlawfully so many people, I will give it fourfold. Now, Jesus, in a way, came into the life of Zacchaeus, not only to identify with him and to, in a way, say that he really cares for him. It was also the purpose of Jesus, as he went into the house of Zacchaeus, to make him understand where he is going wrong. Now, if you look at it very intently, Jesus was not looking at him to condemn him because of the things that he has done wrong, but he was looking at an opportunity to correct him, to make him come to the right place. And the only thing that Jesus did in the life of Zacchaeus was he went and stood with him. And the standing of Jesus next to him, the association that Jesus developed with Zacchaeus, or Zacchaeus developed with Jesus, the relationship itself mended the behavior. Now, Jesus' intention was to correct the life of Zacchaeus and to make him walk a life that will be upright before God. Hallelujah. So love not only cares, love also is willing to correct. Love also intends to correct, to put it correctly. Now, all that we do in our lives, maybe it is circumstantial, maybe we are forced to do a certain thing, maybe our behaviors probably were tuned up right from our childhood days, whatever we could say, but this cannot be an excuse for our wrongdoing before the Lord Almighty. Now we find this love coming in search of us, not just that he cares for us, but also that he wants to correct our lives, mend our wrongdoings, and you know, forgive us and bring us to a place of reconciliation. Now this is very important, because you will have to be receptive when God comes and he corrects you. There are times, you know, the identification of Jesus with us, the relationship with you and me itself will be sufficient for us to be corrected of our ways if only we are willing to submit. So I want you to understand today, love that comes seeking you is not only to care for you, to comfort you, but also this love is looking forward to correct you. This love is looking forward to set right all those things that have gone wrong in your ways. This love is looking for you to be mended, and this love is looking for you to be restored to the glory that God has intended for you. So this can happen only through the love of Jesus. And how does this happen? By submitting yourself and to this relationship of God and to the corrective words of God. There are times we find ourselves so self-centered. There are times we find ourselves better than many people in comparison with their behaviors and attitudes and many things. There are times in our lives where, you know, we are so self-righteous. We are very happy and proud about what we do, the way we read the Bible, the way we fast and pray. But you know, amidst all this, there are areas in our lives where God really wants to make a change. There are places in our heart that are unyielded to the power of God. So when God's love seeks you, it is not just He cares for you, not just to identify with you, not just to comfort you, but the love of God intends to reshape you and bring you to the original glory. Hallelujah. And the third thing I want to share is this love is a love that commissions. We find in John 21, this is the post-resurrection scenario where we find Jesus and Peter having a discussion. Now, Jesus has this question to Peter and he asks him, "Do you really love me?" And you know the answer that Peter gave, and Peter was very immediate in his answer, and he said, "Jesus, you know that I love you." You see, Jesus had this commission that is given to Peter because Jesus knew the kind of mindset that Peter was in. Now, Peter was a person, you know, who was very zealous for God, and he would do anything for God. And this zeal that was in him, you know, it was that zeal that took Jesus all alone when he was sharing about the way that he has to suffer and die. It was that zeal, you know, that took Jesus out and he said, "This is not going to happen to you. You should not be sharing this with the rest of the discipleship group." No, it was that zeal that, you know, immediately said, "Jesus, everybody may leave, but I will not leave you." But you know, only Jesus knew behind that zeal and passion is a very vulnerable little heart. And we find Peter, when Jesus was taken into the house of Pilate, you know, when he was condemned with so many things, when all the other disciples left, Peter was there in the courtyard, and it says, you know, when the sign of the cock crowing happened, he was so brokenhearted. He was so brokenhearted. He had denied the knowledge of Jesus Christ. And when the sign that Jesus gave him came to fulfillment, he was so brokenhearted. Or I would say he was so guilt-stricken. Now when Jesus appears to Peter after the resurrection, Jesus knew the guilt was still there. Because he's the man, you know, after everything was over, he found no purpose in his life other than going back to fishing, and then he went to fishing. He did not identify himself with the great call of God and going forward to serve the Lord and proclaim the good news. Now, Jesus had to correct this one path of his. Jesus had to recommission him to the very calling that he had intended for Peter. So you see, though Peter had backslidden and gone into the fishing trade once again, though he had denied the knowing Jesus, you know, Jesus knew that he had to be brought and placed into the track that he was supposed to walk to. So what he did, he simply came in search of Peter. He came in search of Peter. Hallelujah. You know, Peter, again, we find the zeal and passion inside of him still there. In a way, he identifies that as Jesus. The minute he knew that it was Jesus, he was not waiting for the boat to reach the shore. He jumped into the water, he swam ashore. Behind the zeal and passion was something that had to be set right. In the case of Peter, Jesus had to remove that guilt and shame from him. And Jesus had to recommission him. Jesus had to reiterate that he's supposed to feed a sheep, that he's supposed to be a minister of the word. Hallelujah. And that's exactly what he did. Three times he denied that he did not know Jesus. For the three times that he denied, Jesus commissions him three times. Hallelujah. And he wants him to move forward in life carrying the gospel of Jesus. So this love has come to commission. Today, many of us, probably because of many situations, scenarios, many things that happened in our life, maybe we are away from the path that was intended for us for Jesus. Maybe he had called you into ministry. Maybe you had been doing so many little ministries like praying, like teaching a Sunday school, running a teens group, being an assistant in your church, you know, going help your church folks, visiting people in the hospital. I mean, you had been doing so many things. But for many reasons, like Peter, you don't have this urge to do it anymore, or you have been condemned by people, or you have been sidelined by the ones whom you thought they really cared for you. And because of many things that you saw happen in the ministry or in the church or in your personal life, today you have sidelined yourselves and you just want to keep yourself separate from the call of God, and just you want to walk your own way like the old days. You don't want to be bothered by anything or anyone. You don't want anything to do with ministry or anything. And you are, in a way, for some people, you are, in a way, I should say, you are self-righteous, and you are contented within yourself that whatever you are doing is right and acceptable to God. Today I am here to introduce this love that seeks, that wants to bring you back into the track and bring you back into the calling that God has for you. Hallelujah. So this love not only cares, this love not only corrects, this love also commissions you, or I would say it recommissions you into the calling that he has for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So today Jesus wants you to be back on the track. Hallelujah. If only you can allow yourself to be identified with Jesus again. If only you can give your hearts to Jesus and invite him to come and take over your lives once again. If only, you know, you can accept the invitation of Jesus and take him home with you. I tell you, the love that has come in seek of you, this relentless love, hallelujah, is not going to give up. If only you can give a chance to this love, you will find your whole life bubbling with meaning and joy and purpose once again. I know I'm being very prophetic to some people today as I'm preaching, because as I was preparing, the Lord spoke about some people into my heart. Hallelujah. People who have been neglected. People who are at the verge of giving up on their faith because nothing they expected happened. People who have been sidelined. People who are guilt-stricken because of the things that the Lord commissioned you to do. For some people, the Lord was very clear in saying what to do and what not to do. In spite of that, you had to follow your human instincts and you succumbed to the pressure of people around you. You went into places where, you know, the Lord did not want you to go. You did things that the Lord specifically asked you not to do. And because of which, today you are guilt-stricken, you are not able to move forward from that place of guilt. For many reasons, you have given up your work for Jesus. It is you exactly that the Lord has come to reach out tonight. And I'm not talking about a future tense, I'm talking about a present tense. Now, as you listen to me, there is God next to you. Love has come in search of you. There are so many people who have fallen into the grace of God. They are marching on with Jesus. They are so true to His call. They are so faithful to the call of God. They are being wonderfully used by God. But Jesus has left them in a special care, and He has come in search of you tonight. He wants you to be one of those warriors who will go up front and fight in the army of Jesus. Are you all ready? Would you just close your eyes with me? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, that you have shared this word. Thank you, Jesus, that you have opened up your heart for your children. Lora mahatara kashantara balaba. Meli shahala radianturo karabara baryandaraba. I see, hallelujah, a sister, you are holding a baby in your hands. Amen. And you are crying. You are crying. You have been neglected. Amen. You are so guilt-stricken that you have not obeyed the voice of the Lord, because of which you are suffering. You know, Jesus is come to meet you in the very little room that you are tonight. He has not come there to condemn you. Rather, He has come to commission you back. And this is the word of the Lord for you. Hallelujah. I will lift you from your grave-like situation, and I'm going to honor you, and I'm going to bring you to the place where you will receive honor and glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. And God says, I am sending my help towards you. Hallelujah. Father God, there are people who are contemplating suicide because they have been neglected. Hallelujah. Or in cases they have been accused of many wrongdoings for which they are not part of. And there are some people, Father God, who are so filled with guilt and shame for the things that have happened. Maybe they denounce anything to do that has been already done. Maybe, Father God, in the eyes of the world, they take a stand of not knowing anything wrong that has happened. But deep in their hearts, they know it is because of their mistake or their sin they are going through that consequence. But in spite of all that is true in your life, Jesus' love is still seeking for you. He's going to mend you. He's going to reshape you. And His love is going to recorrect you once again. Hallelujah. Jesus, we come to you. Thank you for the love that seeks. Thank you for the love that cares. Thank you for the love that corrects. Thank you for the love that commissions us back, O Lord. Hallelujah. People of God, all these happened in the life of Peter or in the life of Zacchaeus or anybody in the Word of God. There was simple thing that happened. There was one simple thing that happened. When Jesus was present, they immediately surrendered to Jesus. This is exactly what the Lord is looking forward from you, nothing else. Just give yourselves into the loving hands of Jesus, and you will find your life turning back once again. Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, we honor you. Hallelujah. We give you all glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. And God's people said, Amen and Amen. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Amen. May the love of the Father, the fellowship and the communion and the anointing of the Holy Spirit and the grace of Jesus rest and abide with all of us. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I believe the Lord would have spoken to you through the word. Please do write to us if you have any prayer requests. Don't hesitate to share with us. We are always there for you, ready to pray for you. And the numbers will be displayed on the screen. There is the WhatsApp number. You can always be in touch with us. May the Lord bless you. We will meet you again next week. Thank you.